गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। हेलो
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
सो अंकिता आनंद इज हियर। अंकिता अंकिता आनंद probably roll number 36 or 26 you are here, do you know Ankita is here or not? Actually probably she is suffering from COVID-19, so she informed me also. So she is here or not? Probably Ankita, have you joined now? Ankita Anand? Okay. So except Ankita, all of you,
sir,
anyone? Bolo.
So please accept her, Ankita Anand.
Ankita Anand, so... Where is Ankita? No, she is not trying to join here. I'm not finding it.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, last day at the day of test, so we have taken on MCQ also. So at that day, she informed that she is suffering from COVID-19. So I am asking, she is now fine or. So last day she informed that she is not in her home also, outside to for the COVID-19 situation also. So anyone from you so are suffering from that type of, because you know that this is very critical situation, we are facing very critical situations also. So obviously we are staying in our home and with all types of safety. So I am telling to you also, you will maintain it, and if anybody is suffering from that type of situation, so you will inform me, so I will talk with you. Okay, so anyway, so after the class I will talk with her also, what is the present situation. So anyway, in that time, so we are bound also to read something, otherwise mentally we are also we will be also sharper otherwise. So anyway, so last day all of you probably except one or two students, almost all the students also giving the test MCQ, and on the basis of MCQ, on the basis of your test, on the basis of your attendance, and today you know this is the today is the last day to submission the assignment also. Some students already submitted the assignment in the Google Classroom. And left of the students, I am telling you, left of the students immediately will submit the assignment within today, because last day I told you that today is the last day. Okay. So now in our electrochemistry, probably last day already we have discussed how the electrode potential will be calculated. This is very important in any electrochemical cell. What is the EMF value? What is the electrode potential value? So the electrode potential value or E, that will be calculated, that will be determined with the help of the Nernst equation. And lastly, already we have derived the Nernst equation. What is this? So if we know the standard electrode potential value, and if we know the concentration of the electrolyte, concentration of the salt, so we can determine the unknown electrode potential value also. So to determine the electrode potential value, so first thing is required, that is the E naught, that is the standard electrode potential value. Last day already we have explained what is this, what is the standard electrode potential value. When the electrode potential value will be determined at the standard condition, at standard temperature pressure, that will be the standard electrode potential value. And another thing is required, that is the concentration of the electrolyte. So to make an electrochemical cell, you know that two electrodes are required, on each anode, another each cathode, positive or negative electrode. So the two electrodes are also present in the electrolyte. So the concentration of the electrolyte is also very much important. So last year already we have derived the equation, that is E is equal to E naught minus 0.059 by N. What is N? What is N? How it will be determined? We'll give the answer quickly. What is N? How we will get the moles? So, yes, but that is moles. But in our determination, suppose in the cell reaction, how you will determine what will be the value of N? I told you that to determine the electrode potential, what we'll do, first we'll write the chemical reaction. First, we'll write the chemical reaction which is occurring on the surface of the electrode, or overall chemical reaction. So in the chemical reaction, how much number of electrons are participating in the reaction? So that will be the value of N. Now, is it clear? So during the determination, we have considered N is equal to mole. So in the chemical reaction, if you write the chemical reaction, we are able to write the chemical reaction, suppose zinc sulfate. So zinc 2 plus. So in this way, if you write the chemical reaction, we can get the number of electrons which are participating in the reaction. So that will be the value of N. Now, is it clear? So to determine the electrode potential, the N value will be the number of electrons participating in the reaction. And I told you that activity of product by activity of reactant. Now we can consider concentration of product and concentration of reactants also. So if we know this value, we can determine the electrode potential value also. So through the Nernst equation, that is the conclusion, through the Nernst equation at any given temperature, if we know the reactant concentration, product concentration, we can determine the electrode potential value. So already we have, yes.
Now accepted, Ankitanand. Now accept her, Ankitanand.
Oh. Okay. Already we have discussed what is the EMF, what is the electromotive force. Last year already we have discussed electromotive force means due to the differences of the potential or electrode potential in between two electrodes. So we can say that electricity will flow from the one electrode to another electrode due to the having a differences of potential. So that is known as the electrode potential value. That is known as the E. And there are two electrodes also. You know, one is considered as the oxidation potential electrode, another is the reduction potential electrode. Oxidation potential electrode means where the electron will be gathered. That means oxidation means removal of electron. So on that electrode, so the electrons will be increased. So electron concentration will be increased. That is also considered as the negative potential. Oxidation electrode, so that will be the negative potential. And another will be the reduction potential. So electrode, that will be the positive potential also. Okay. And we know that electron will flow from the oxidation potential electrode to the reduction potential. Now, so we'll discuss now also the half cell. Half cell means, so before discussing the net cell EMF, so I'm telling what is half cell. You have the idea about the half cell. So I'm telling that in an electrochemical cell, you know, in an electrochemical cell, two electrodes are required. And on two electrodes, on the surface of the two electrodes, the chemical reactions also are occurring. From the chemical reaction, we are getting the electricity. Right, on the chemical reaction we are getting the electricity. So on the surface of the electrode, so the chemical reactions also are occurring. So there are two electrode, and one electrode oxidation, another electrode reductions are also occurring. So individual electrode is known as the huxley. There are two electrode. So individual electrode, that may be the positive, that may be the negative. So the individual electrode is considered as the huxley also. So the electrode potential difference value, or the E value, or the E cell value, how that will be the calculated? So we can say that left hand side electrode, we are considering left hand side electrode oxidation is occurring and right hand side electrode reduction is occurring. So the oxidation potential plus reduction potential, so that will be the E cell. I am telling you, this is very important. Oxidation potential on the left hand side electrode, it is indicated as L, and reduction potential on the right hand side electrode. So both the electrode potential, that will be the E cell, total electrode potential, right? But we know that we can write this electrode, suppose E oxidation left, we can write also minus E reduction left, E oxidation left, that value, suppose the value is X. So we can write that minus E reduction L, we can write it also. So it will be E reduction R minus E reduction L. Is it clear or not? First we are writing that E cell is equal to E oxidation plus E reduction. Oxidation occurring on the left hand side and reduction on the right hand side. And we will get some values also, right? But if we convert in the two potential, in the reduction potential value, that is already present as the reduction potential, but the E oxidation potential, which is oxidation occurring on the left hand side electrode, we can write that minus E reduction potential also on the left hand side. So it will be ER minus EL. ER minus EL. Maximum students are also confusing that. So they are getting some values in their problem, in their question paper. Suppose both the values are indicated as the reduction potential. In that case, we can write that ER minus EL. When we are considering reduction potential value. But oxidation is occurring on the left hand side. I am not telling that the reduction is occurring on the left hand side. Oxidation is occurring on the left hand side. But when we are writing as the reduction potential value, only the sign will be opposite. So we are writing that ER minus EL. So you can write on the oxidation potential value also EL minus ER when we are considering both are oxidation. But you will see that in the electrochemical series, we are getting the values of the electrode as the reduction potential value. So that is better to know that E cell is equal to ER minus EL. Is it clear to everybody why we are writing E cell is equal to ER minus EL? If you get the individual oxidation and reduction value, so there is no problem. You can only sum up these two values also. But if you get the value as the reduction potential, so you will write the E cell is equal to ER minus EL. Okay, right hand side electrode potential minus left hand side electrode potential, all the potential value described as the reduction potential. Clear? So at the same way, standard net cell EMF. So in the non-stickation, we have seen that E is equal to E naught. E is equal to E naught. There is no indication that E naught means E naught of left hand side or E naught of right hand side. Actually, E naught means E naught R minus E naught L. E naught R minus E naught L when both are considered as the reduction potential. E naught R minus E naught L when both are considered as the reduction potential. Or you can write that E naught L minus E naught R when both are considered as the oxidation potential. So first we'll determine the E naught value, standard electrode potential value. So after that we can put the standard electrode potential value in the non-stuckation, and we will determine the electrode potential value of that particular electrochemical cell. So now up to that we have discussed that to determine the electrode potential, so individual electrode potential value is important. Am I right? To determine the electrode potential value using the non-stuckation, individual electrode potential value, to know, to determine the individual electrode potential value is important also. So first thing is that to determine the individual, there are so many electrodes. suppose the metal rods, metal sticks are using the different metal rods also are using as the electrode also. So how it will be determined? How the individual electrode potential value will be determined? So first, so to determine the individual electrode potential, first we will consider some standard electrode also. Standard electrode, one more important and most popular standard electrode, probably you know, that is the hydrogen electrode. Hydrogen electrode. So that is most popular electrode as the standard half cell or standard hydrogen electrode, SHG, that is the hydrogen electrode. What is, how it will be formed? Because you know that hydrogen is the gaseous substance. Generally, we know that hydrogen is the gaseous substance. But to make an electrode, so that will be obviously solid substance. The cell reactions also occurring on the solid. That means to make the standard hydrogen electrode, we will use the pure platinum rod. First, to make the standard hydrogen electrode, so we will use the pure platinum rod. So that is the formation of the standard hydrogen electrode. When the pure platinum rod dipped in the hydrogen plus solution, so generally the concentration of hydrogen plus is 1 molar, one. Yes, continue passing in that way that the pure hydrogen gas, which will pass through the hole and continuously bubbling on the surface of the platinum rod. This arrangement is known as the standard hydrogen electrode. I am repeating again. So to make the standard hydrogen electrode, we are using the platinum rod. So when the pure platinum rod, so why we are using the pure platinum rod? So we can consider that the platinum cannot react with the hydrogen also. So when we are using the pure platinum rod, so and it is dipped in the hydrogen plus solution, which concentration is 1 molar. At that time, if the pure hydrogen plus continuously bubbling on the surface of the platinum rod, so this arrangement is known as the standard hydrogen electrode. So standard hydrogen electrode, the cell representation will be the platinum, hydrogen gas to hydrogen plus approach. And that will be the reaction, half hydrogen to hydrogen plus plus electron. So I told you that to write the chemical reaction, it is very important, because when you determine the electrode potential value, so number of electrons also required. So first we'll write the chemical reaction, half H2 to H plus plus electron. This reaction is occurring on the surface of the platinum. So we have taken the pure platinum rod, so we can consider it is inert with respect to hydrogen. So there is no reaction. So only the hydrogen will convert into the hydrogen plus in presence of platinum. Now that will be the reaction, that will be the presentation in the non-stick equations also. So in non-stick equation, we are writing in this way. So first we are determining EH2, electrode potential of hydrogen, standard electrode potential of hydrogen, minus 0.059 by N log hydrogen plus 2, which hydrogen to the power half. So just that was the gaseous hydrogen. We have written that a hydrogen gas. So we have taken in the form of pressure to the half, and or EH2 is equal to E0 H2 minus 0.059 by 1, because we know that N value, that is 1, log concentration of hydrogen plus, that is one pure hydrogen gas, so that is one, so we have taken at one atmosphere, that will be one. So again, the standard electrode potential value, E naught value of the hydrogen electrode, that is also considered as zero. So the scale is starting from the hydrogen gas also in the electrochemical series, you know. So standard electrode potential value of hydrogen, that is considered as the zero. So we can say that zero minus 0.059 log concentration of hydrogen plus, and you know, minus log concentration of hydrogen plus, that is known as the pH. And this is very, very important relationship also. electrode potential of hydrogen, that is 0.059 pH. So if you know the concentration of hydrogen plus, if you know the pH of the solution, so you can determine what will be the electrode potential value. So now, once you have determined the electrode potential value of hydrogen, you can use this electrode potential value to determine the unknown electrode potential value. So that is the application. I am telling again and again, that is the application, that is the necessity of the standard hydrogen electrode, standard half cell, to determine the unknown electrode potential. See, here that is one unknown electrode, so we don't know what is the electrode potential value, suppose zinc electrode. So we have used the hydrogen, that is on the left hand side, that is on the right hand side. So that will be the reaction, NOB reaction, that will be half hydrogen to hydrogen plus, and cathodic reaction Zn2 plus plus to electron to Zn. So in this way, that will be the total cell reaction. And next, put in the Nernst equation. Already we know that experimentally it is observed that the standard cell potential also E naught cell is equal to this using the zinc electrode. So, and this value is 0 also, already we know. So E naught value, E naught cell is equal to E naught this plus this, and the total is 0.76 from the instrument we are getting it. So individual standard electrode potential of zinc, that will be determined, because always we know that standard electrode potential of hydrogen is 0. Standard electrode potential of hydrogen is 0. So when it is connected with an unknown electrode, so easily we can determine what will be the electrode potential value. So in this way, one by one, we can determine the unknown electrode potential value. There is the copper electrode also, that will be the electrode potential value of copper, which is 0.34 volt. Okay. So now, next, if we connect the zinc and the copper electrode. Now, already you know that each one very important cell, electrochemical cell also, where the two electrode zinc and copper also present. So when two electrodes are connected, so we can easily determine the E naught cell also, standard electrode potential value also. Because already we have determined the standard electrode potential value of zinc, standard electrode potential of copper. So ultimately, by addition of this, so we are getting this also. Because one is oxidation, another is reduction, we are not writing the ER minus EL. When we are considering oxidation and reduction, so both will be added. Clear? But if you consider that is also reduction, so it will be minus. So ER minus here. Otherwise, you can add another standard hydrogen. Sorry, standard half cell. That is the calomel electrode. Calomel means that is also one Latin word, calomel. So mercurous chloride, which is known as the calomel in that country. Mercurous chloride. So Hg2Cl2. Now we are using the we know the actual name. So you can use as the calomel also. It is used in the electrochemical cell, so the name of the electrode is the calomel electrode. Mercurous chloride, Hg2Cl2. So what is the arrangement of the calomel cell? See, that is the KCl solution saturated with the mercurous chloride. Next part, that is covered by the solid paste of the mercurous chloride with mercury, pure mercury. That is the paste of the mercurous chloride and mercury. There is the KCl solution, there is the mercurous chloride and mercury, and next the pure mercury also. And at the end, there will be one platinum wire. Again, that is used as the pure platinum wire, because we are not using the mercury as the electrode also. The platinum will help to determine the electrode potential in the calomel electrode. I am discussing again the arrangement. So that is the KCl solution. Next, the one paste of the pure mercury and mercurous chloride. Next, the pure mercury and one platinum rod also dipped in the pure mercury. That is the arrangement. And that is the cell representation, mercury liquid, you know, Hg2Cl2 one paste, so that is solid, and Cl minus, that is the aqueous also. KCl. From the KCl solution, so see, that is also important. From the KCl solution, we are getting the Cl minus. Now that will be the reaction. Hg2Cl2 2Hg plus 2Cl minus 2Hg plus 2 electron. Overall reaction will be Hg2Cl2 plus 2E 2 electron, Hg liquid plus Cl. So now put in the non-stuccation. So we are putting the non-stuccation. E calomel is equal to standard electrode potential of calomel minus 0.059 by N. Again, that is the indicating of number of electrons which are participating in the reaction. Log concentration of Hg to the power 2 Cl minus 2 to Hg 2 Cl 2. So now Hg and Hg 2 Cl 2. Hg and Hg 2 Cl 2 all are in the pure state. We are considering the concentration that will be unit also. We can reduce from both sides. Only that is important to know the value of the concentration of Cl minus. From where the Cl minus is coming? From the KCl solution. From the KCl solution in the calomel electrode at the top, so position, so KCl is present with the saturated condition. So now on the basis of the concentration of Cl minus, so now later after formation of the calomel electrode, we can use the different concentration of Cl KCl solution. So on the basis of the concentration, there are different name also. All are important as the MCQ. When the Cl or KCl solution is present as the saturated form, the name of the calomel electrode will be saturated calomel electrode. I am repeating again. So when the KCl solution is present in the electrode as the saturated form, so the name of the calomel electrode will be the saturated calomel electrode. When the Cl minus or the KCl solution, the concentration will be one normal, so the name of the calomel electrode will be normal calomel electrode. And when the concentration of the KCl solution will be N by 10, so the name of the calomel electrode will be decinormal calomel electrode. So we have three types of calomel electrode. We can make three types of calomel electrode: saturated when the KCl solution is in saturated state, normal calomel electrode when the KCl solution concentration will be one normal, decinormal calomel electrode when the KCl solution strength will be N by 10. Okay, so there are three types of calomel electrode. Again, using the calomel electrode, we can determine the pH of a solution also. So very simple. So again, the calomel electrode is connected with the hydrogen electrode. Calomel electrode is connected with the hydrogen electrode. So E cell is equal to E hydrogen electrode plus E calomel electrode. That is the 0.059 pH we know, plus E calomel. So pH is equal to E cell. From the instrument, we will get the E cell value also. E cell minus E calomel by 0.05. In this way, using the calomel electrode, attaching with the hydrogen electrode, so we can again determine the pH value. So from the electrochemical cell, that is also one very important application also, we can determine the pH value of the solution. Now, I told you that the electrochemical cell or the electrode potential value, it is also connected with the thermodynamics. Because in the electrochemical cell, we know, so initially last day already we have determined what will be the value of del G. That is very important. Del G is indicating the available energy, free energy to do the work. So similarly, with the help of the electrode potential value, we can determine the value of H, del H. We can determine the value of del S also. If we know the del S, del H, del G, these are very, very important parameter to identify the process also. The electrochemical reaction will be the spontaneous or non-spontaneous. Are you understanding or not? That is the application of the electrochemical cell. If we know the electrode potential value or the coefficient of electrode potential value, that is dE by dt, we can determine these three important parameters, del G, del H, del S. So if we once we know the value of del G, del H, del S, so we can say that the cell reaction is spontaneous or non-spontaneous. So this relationship already we have developed, del G is equal to del H minus T del S. So del g is equal to del h plus t in the presence of del s. Again, we can write from the when we have discussed the Gibbs and Mohs equation, we have got this relationship. So d by dt del g, and del g is equal to minus nfe. So ultimately, we have got that del h value, del g value already we have determined, nfe, del h value, that will be the del h value. And that is the del s value. Again, in the place of del g, we can put the minus nf del e also. That means n value, f value, both are the constant value. N value, f value. N means number of electrons or number of moles. F is equal to 96,500 coulomb. So only if you know the e value, electrode potential value, or e value at different temperature, so you can determine the value of del s and del h and del g also. And all the parameter will indicate that the cell reaction is spontaneous or non-spontaneous. Generally, we know that in the galvanic shell, so from the spontaneous cell reaction, we are getting the electricity. That is the favorable process. From the spontaneous cell reaction, so from the spontaneous cell reaction means, if you calculate the del g value, obviously we will get the negative. If you calculate the del h value, obviously it will be the negative, and the del s value, it will be the positive. See, on the del s minus of this, again del g is equal to minus, so minus minus, that will be plus. So del s positive, that is the indication of the spontaneous. Del g negative, that is the indication of spontaneous. Del h negative, that is the indication of spontaneous. So these are the application in the thermodynamics, the application of electrode potential. Okay. So elaborately we have written here also, s is equal to this, we have got the s value also. So next day we'll start the water chemistry. You have the idea about the water chemistry also, what is mainly the, in the first part of the water chemistry already we have read in your previous level. So mainly we will discuss here in the water chemistry different type of corrosion and how it will be removed, what is the effect of the corrosion on the metal. So that will be discussed in the water chemistry. Okay, so in water chemistry, first we will discuss the different characteristic of properties of different types of water. You know probably hard water, soft water, which are the reason for the hard water, how it will be removed, how we will get the soft water from the hard water, and after that we will discuss the corrosion. So next we will start the water chemistry. So, Mohammad Sajib Khan. Sajib?
Yes, sir.
Till now, you are not fixing your profile photo also, your own photo. I am getting only M, capital A. Why? All the students also showing their photo here, except you. From the beginning, I am telling that in your profile, so your photo will be there.
Okay, so I will change my profile.
So if you face any problem, you can ask to your friends also. You are the IT students, okay. They can help you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now roll number one.
Roll number present, one.
Sir. Okay. Two.
Present, sir.
Present, sir.
Three. Four.
Present, sir.
Five.
Present, sir.
Six.
Present, sir.
Seven.
Present, sir.
Eight.
Present, sir.
Nine.
Present, sir.
Ten. Roll number ten. 11.
Present, sir.
12.
Present, sir.
13.
Present, sir.
14.
Present, sir.
15.
Present, sir.
16.
Present, sir.
17.
Yes, sir.
18.
Present, sir.
19.
Present, sir.
20.
Present, sir.
21.
Present, sir.
22. 23.
Present, sir.
24.
Present, sir.
25.
Yes, sir.
26.
Present.
27.
Present, sir.
28.
Present, sir.
29.
Present, sir.
26. Ankita, 26 roll number. Ankita. Ankita Anand. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Ankita, now you are fine?
Yes, sir.
So are you suffering from the corona COVID-19?
Yes, sir.
So now it is negative. Have you done the test or not? Ankita?
Yes, sir.
Have you done the test or not?
Sir, am I audible?
Audible. You are audible. I am asking that, have you done the test? COVID test,
yes,
or no? Okay. So now,
yes,
that now the test report is negative?
No, sir, it's still positive.
So how many days before you have done the test?
So day before yesterday.
Before yesterday. So is there any symptom now or not? So are you suffering from fever or any other symptom?
Yes, sir. I have cough and only cough.
So in your family, except you, any other members are also suffering or not?
Yes, sir. My mother is suffering from COVID-19.
Okay. Okay, very seriously. Take care. The situation is very dangerous also. All are also under pressure. So your mother also is suffering hold the fell. So one by one, so that is dangerous virus also. One by one, you also are suffering, your mother's also, and lift up the member maybe will suffer also. So take care. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Roll number 30.
Yes, sir.
40. 41.
Present, sir.
Sir.
Sir, 31.
Oh, sorry. Sorry. Number 30, after the 31.
Present, sir.
32.
Present, sir.
33.
Present, sir.
34.
Present, sir.
35. 35. 36.
Present, sir.
37.
Present, sir.
38.
Present, sir.
39. 40.
Present, sir. 40.
41.
Present, sir.
42.
42, present, sir.
43.
Present, sir.
44.
Present, sir.
45. 46.
Present, sir.
47.
Present, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. 47. Yes, sir.
48.
Present, sir.
49.
Yes, sir.
50.
Present, sir.
51.
Present, sir.
52.
Sir.
52. 53.
Present, 52, present, sir.
53.
Present, sir.
54.
Present, sir.
55.
Present, sir.
56.
Present, sir.
57.
Present, sir.
58.
Present, sir.
59.
Present, sir.
60.
Present, sir.
61. 62.
Present, sir.
63.
Present, sir.
64.
Present, sir.
65.
Present, sir.
66.
Present, sir.
67.
Present, sir.
68.
Present.